Hello guys, welcome to Hacking with Anascreen. So in previous videos, we set up this Metasploit tool too. So I'm just going to start it. So it is running on background. See, so all the things are setting up. So username is MSF admin and password is MSF admin. I press enter. See, now I am in Metasploit tool 2 machine. Now I'm going to type IP config. Sorry, that's for Windows command ifconfig. Okay, now this is the IP address 192.168.56.105. So now the server is started. So I'm opening Kali Linux. So in Kali Linux, I'm going to open Firefox browser. So now I am typing the IP address here 192.168.56.105. Pressing enter. So now I am in a Metasploitable machine. I'm just canceling it. So these are the vulnerable website for testing and learning. So I request you guys to use this multi-layer. So this is born to be hacked. Why I am saying is, so this OWASP 10 type of bug, top 10 bugs like SQL injection, XSS, so broken authentication, cookie login sections. So all the 10 types are listed here. So when we click this, so user info, this page will be loaded, vulnerable page will be loaded here. So we can bypass by using various methods, by injecting malicious code in name and password, that our SQL injection will bypass. Also, yes, the documentation and resources. So all the things are available here. So pull control, login are registered. So all the things will be, so you want to reset the database. So the reset, so the database will be resetted. So toggle security. So all the things we are going to see in later sections. So next, so I'm going to say the file thing, just go to normal. So I'm going to DBWA. So admin password is PASSWORD password. So I never save password. If you guys see here, brute force, command execution, cross site request forgery. So file implosion, so all type of bug will be listed here. So this is for practice. So what is the main thing is, I'm clicking on about section. See, the version is a old version. It's a 2010 version. So we are going to use a latest version. So all the things, all the websites first we are going to see in DBWA. Then only you can understand, and then we move to this multi-tier. So first, we need to set up a latest version of DBWA in Kali Linux. So then we are using this all the type of bugs in next videos. First we are going to see what is DBWA and find all the type of bugs. Then only we move to multi-tier, then web DBA. So all the things we are going to see line by line. So this is the old version. So I want new version. So I'm opening a new tab. So typing here DBWA. Just press enter. So I'm closing this. See, first link is dbwa.co.uk. So I'm going to this link. So this is the web application. So I'm not clicking here download. I'm going to source control. So the GitHub page will open here. You guys see, on April 19th is the latest update in 2021. So I'm clicking here code and I'm downloading this zip. So I'm saving this file. Okay. So this code is, this vulnerable website is successfully downloaded. Yeah. So next we are going to set up a server called XAMPP. So it is an Apache server. So I'm going to click the first link. See, so for Windows, for Linux, for OS. So this all the process is same in Windows, Mac OS, in Linux. So I'm using Linux, Kali Linux. So I am pressing this because it works on PHP 8.0.6. So it's a normal version, so no need to worry. So just click on OK. So the php.run is installing, sorry, the XFM server.run is installing. So if you guys don't know how to install it, so you are reading install instructions. So click on Linux, click on CX to questions. How do I install? See, there is a instruction to install XAMPP server. So now I am navigating to this download page, open folder. See the exam. So I download 2 times. So I'm deleting this one. So the exam server and DVWA. So I'm right clicking and extract the file here. So the file extracted. So this is the file extracted. So the folder successfully extracted. So this is the vulnerable web page code DVWS. So okay, now we are going to install this. So I am closing this. So I'm opening. First we have to install the change the permission. So I'm copying this code. I click copy. So go to downloads. I click open terminal. So we need to change the permission. So to change the permission, so I'm minimizing this. I click paste. Just press enter. So I'm changing the permission. Or you can right click, go to properties, here permission. So you can change the permission here. So I'm changing with the code as given here. So to run the installer, so we need to run this. So I'm copying this and paste it here. See, it's showing in red color because it is not installed. So I'm pressing enter. So it started installing. See, so it's going to start installing. Next, so next, next, next. Okay, the web page has opened, saying install. So now it's starting to install. So it will be graphical user interface. So I'm minimizing it. So I'm pausing this video because it's installing. It takes time. Okay, the server setup is completed successfully. So I'm not launching this app, just finish. We need to change the modifications. So we are in a download directory. So I'm going to rename this. I click rename. So only I call it as DVWA. So rename it. So I'm just copying this and go to file system. So if you want to access this file system, you need to be a root user. See, I'm a root user. So if you guys don't know how to be a root user, so see my previous videos and say about it. So go to in file system, go to options, in LAMP, go to this LAMPP and go to HD docs. So right click, paste it here. So it pasted successfully. The another thing we have to do is go to this DVWA folder on the config. So we need to rename this. So right click and rename. So just erase this last extension DIST and the before dot. Only it end with PHP. So I renamed it. So that's it, guys. Okay, now we set up all the things. So in frequently asked question, we installed. So now how to start exam. So simply sudo so opt lamp and lamp start to execute this command to start a server. So just I am in this lamp lamp folder. So I'm in here. So I just right click, open the terminal here. So you guys can see opt lamp. So I'm in opt lamp. So I'm typing lamp start. So I'm just press enter. So you guys don't know, just open a new terminal in root user. Just copy this. So I'm pasting here. Just click enter. So see, that's I am already running. So if you guys start, you look like this. Sorted. So not now what we have to do is, so the server is started successfully. So I'm closing all the tab. So opening a new tab. I'm typing here local host, pressing enter. See, the exam server is working good. So now what we have to do is, instead of this dashboard, erase it and type in capital letter DVWA, pressing enter. See, we are now in a DVWA page. So how this happened? So I'm just going to just go to this and HD doc where we paste here. So here we paste DVWA. So this name is given here. So that's it, guys. So see, but we have to do something. So something is, so it's showing allow URL include is disabled. Now we have to enable it. Also, it is not a root user, so we need to change it. So I'm clicking here. So now I am in option lamp. So we have tested here DBWA. I'm opening this config. So I'm opening this. So we change it to PHP. Now down here. So I don't want any password. So I am canceling this. So I leave it as none. So user ID is, I want to be a root user. .wo.d. So that's it. Control plus S, save. So now what I'm going to do, just open and reload it. So just click here and create a reset database. So you will be seen with this successful on the login pages. Okay. So now what we have to do is this admin password, admin password. Press enter. You will be inside DB Diamond Vulnerable Web Application DBWA. So now when I click about, see, it is August 2021. So it is latest version. So we are going to test a bug in the latest version. Also guys, we learn here how the bug, this file upload bug works, all the things here, because I cannot show in a live web page because that is illegal. So some of the, if access reflected bugs, I can show in a live website in next videos, but it's stored DOM based accesses, file upload, this is all severe bugs. So I'm using this web page to teach you guys. So here, DBWA security, and I click here. See, it's there are four types: low level, medium, high level, impossible. So impossible means it's highest security, we cannot hack, but we are going to try it and see all the informations. So here's the PHP info. So version 8.0.6, this website run on PHP. They say there is a php.php. Okay guys, you guys understand what is this DBWA, how to set up example. Also there is a tab called instruction. So all the license documentation will be listed here. You guys can learn from this documentations. So SQL injection won't work on 5.2.6 PHP version. So how, why the SQL injection not work? So there will be a detailed answer in it. So all the things have been documented here. You guys can visit in instruction. If you're working on it, so if you change in anything or anything, but you want fresh, just click on setup reset database. By clicking here, click on create a reset database. That's it. The database will be resetted. In down, you can see the database has been created, all the things set up successful. So that's it guys. I hope you guys understand how to set up DBWA latest version in Kali Linux. So the first and basic bug is XSS. So in next video, we are going to see this XSS bug in live website, how to find using Webshoot. If you're going to want the Webshoot Pro version, click download in description and download the Webshoot Pro version. Again, I'm telling it contains some viruses. In community version, you can use, but it is a manual process. Okay guys, thanks for watching.